I recently put out a video on whether I-bonds or the 30-year TIPS is the best investment. Since then, the Treasury Department has recently issued the updated interest rate for I-bonds, so I decided to do a summary of the comparison. Although I calculated the new variable interest rate for I-bonds using inflation data, I did not know what the fixed rate was going to be, since there is no formula for determining that, at least not one that's public. The new fixed rate for I-bonds is 0.9%, making the annualized composite rate equal to 4.3%, which includes the variable portion. The coupon rate for Treasury Inflation-Protected Securities, otherwise known as TIPS, that will be issued in August 2023 is 1.5%. The coupon rate stays the same for the 30-year life of the bond, but the principal is adjusted according to inflation. Even though the coupon rate remains the same, interest payments increase as the adjusted principal increases with inflation. The investment return consists of the adjusted principal plus the coupon payments, which are received semi-annually. As you can see from this table, a 30-year TIPS has a higher real interest rate than the current issue of I-bonds. But, as I will show later, this comparison is more complicated than it seems. There is a limit of how much can be purchased of either security. For TIPS, the limit is $10 million. For I-bonds, the limit is $10,000. As I will show later, the capital gain potential for 30-year TIPS is tremendous, while the capital gain potential for I-bonds is zero. I-bonds cannot be resold. They can only be redeemed by the federal government. So while there is no interest rate risk with I-bonds, there is also no capital gain potential. Now I am going to show a direct comparison between these two securities. However, because investment returns for both securities depend on future inflation rates, it cannot be determined beforehand what actual investment returns will be. Nonetheless, a direct comparison can be made by using average inflation rates. By using the CPI inflation calculator provided by the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics, the overall inflation rate from January 1993 to March 2023 was about 112%, which comes out to about 3.7% annually. One reason why the fixed rate of I-bonds is not directly comparable to the coupon rate of TIPS is because the interest in I-bonds is compounded semi-annually, whereas the interest earned from TIPS is paid out semi-annually, so it is not compounded. But the interest payments of TIPS increase as the principal is adjusted with inflation. So using the published interest rates of these two securities, based on the 3.7% annual inflation rate of the past 30 years, I calculated the total return for both types of securities. As you can see here, over the 30-year term of these securities, TIPS returned a profit of 366% compared to 293% of the total profit for I-bonds. Clearly, TIPS provide a larger investment return over I-bonds, just in terms of the interest paid plus the inflation adjustments. However, as I said earlier, TIPS also provide a much greater potential for capital gains, gains which can easily exceed that of the stock market, whereas the potential capital gains of I-bonds is zero, because I-bonds cannot be resold. They can only be redeemed by the government. If you want to learn more details about TIPS, check out my other video on TIPS, which provides more basic information. A link is provided in the description below. Duration measures the sensitivity of the market price of a bond to changes in interest rates. Duration is the weighted average maturity time of all payments. Graphically, the duration of a bond can be envisioned as a fulcrum placed under a seesaw so as to balance the weights of the present values of the coupon payments and the principal payment. Both a longer-term maturity and a lower coupon rate results in a longer duration. A longer duration means that a security could be sold for a higher capital gain when interest rates decline. Although duration is a useful measure, the duration of TIPS cannot be measured. Duration depends on future cash flows, and because both the interest payments and the principal payment depend on the adjustments to principal, which, in turn, depend on future inflation, there is no way to measure the duration of TIPS. Nonetheless, it is certain that the duration is long, since the term of the bond is 30 years, and most of the cash flow occurs at maturity. This table illustrates the potential for capital gains. Because future cash flows for TIPS is unknowable, I displayed what the theoretical prices would be for the 30-year Treasury bond, when interest rates decline from 5% to 0.25%. As you can see here, if interest rates decline to 1% or less, then you will have a capital gain exceeding 100%. This could happen within a few years. How long would it take for the stock market to double? Because the duration of 30 years TIPS is even longer, the price should increase even more when interest rates decline. But even an interest rate decline of only 2 or 3% can result in capital gains of 40% to 67%.
Most securities are free of credit default risk, and they are not subject to state or local taxes. One thing you should note is that the taxation of I-bonds and TIPS differ. With I-bonds, you do not have to pay taxes until the bond is redeemed or until it matures. Another advantage of I-bonds is that if the interest is used to pay for qualified educational expenses, then the interest is tax-free. A big disadvantage of TIPS is that taxes are due both on the semi-annual interest payments and the adjustments to principal, so it is best to hold TIPS in a tax-advantaged retirement account. Check out my in-depth video about I-bonds. Also, check out my detailed video on the taxation of savings bonds.
Thank you very much for your time. If you liked my video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe. I would appreciate any suggestions, so please leave them in the comments below. Check out my website at thismatter.com for more than 850 in-depth fundamental tutorials on personal finance, investments, and economics. Check out my books on money at williamspalding.com. Thank you.